Today is important, and yet the days ahead are even more important in terms of gender parity in our country. Kwanza, you will recall, ladies governors, and I want you to listen to me, because some of you are from Kenya Kwanza, and I want to send you to your party leader. So, I deserve just 1 minute, so I can send you to your party leader. I gave a report of NADCO, National Dialogue Committee, to both Raila and to Ruto. And I finished my work with regard to the issue of the two-thirds gender rule. I finished my work. We have generated 8 pieces of legislation, one of which is amendment to Elections Act 2011. I have finished my work. And under that amendment, all political parties will be required to adhere to the two-thirds gender rule when they are doing their party nominations. But for that to happen, you need to tell your party leader, to tell the people in parliament, to now use the political will and expeditiously enact amendment to Elections Act 2011. If you don't do that, you will have missed this opportunity. And I think it's just a window. Any window opportunity kidogo sana. If you don't take advantage of this window, then the window may close. It is as simple as that. I've just come from the Law Society Conference, and we are the senior council bar, as well as the now ongoing Law Society Conference. Ladies in Kenya, do not need to be sycophantic about who they are. The example has been set in Nakuru and in Machakos. If you have the right quality leadership, you will make it. Madam Aida, you don't even have to encourage the talk of group 24. They can very easily, if the current group 7 show leadership qualities that will endear the leadership of the women folk in our country, believe you me, they can even go up to 30 governors. I see no problem. But if the current crop do not embrace what you have unveiled here today, complete with an advisory council led by Mama Aida, then you may be a discouragement to others. So this is why I started by congratulating you, Governor Avinya, for what you have showcased in Machakos. I cannot stand here and say, Governor Avinya, kuwa re-elected or no re-elected, kazi yako ndiye itakufanya uwe re-elected ama uende nyumbani. Sinamnayo? So she has done well. And so, because I'm a party leader, I don't want other leaders to say I've endorsed to Avinya for 2027. If your own leaders do that, they'll be putting you into a lot of trouble. Munanielewa? To congratulate Governor Avinya, you seem to have read the mood in the country, and you have given time to the youth, to the Gen Z's. This is what your colleague there is taking home. Our young people died. Over 300 of them. Wamepigwa risasi wakauawa. Kwa makosa gani? Walikuwa nabeba bendera ya Kenya. Our national pride, just like our athletes have done in Paris. 11 gold medals, 11 medals, 4 of them gold medals. And they were proudly carrying the national flag. The next thing the Gen Z's were armed with was a bottle of water, chupa ya maji, and their telephone. Ladies and gentlemen, lady governors, if you think the Gen Z story is over, you are deceiving yourselves. This country will never be the same in terms of governance. It will never, never be the same. President Paul Kagame has done well in Rwanda, 50-50. I give you my pledge as party leader of Wiper Democratic Movement, a member party of Azimio Coalition. Our principled position is 50-50 gender parity. We have made it very clear in our manifesto and wherever. God willing, people of Machakos, people of Kenya, Your Excellencies, Lady Governors, please take note, your country has changed. And I don't want to elaborate beyond that. And people expect nothing but transparency, inclusivity. They don't want stealing people. Wamebiwa ya kutosha. Wamedanganywa ya kutosha.